What's up, guys, and it's time to take a look at the first glimpse of Samsung's next software creation, that is the One UI 5.0 based on Android 13. Yes, believe it or not, we actually got our first look at the One UI 5.0, revealing some of the new improvements and changes we have. We're going to be taking a look at everything. Now, just a heads up, this is not the actual public beta. It's not out yet. This is the internal One UI 5.0 version, and by the time we get the public beta, there's definitely going to be more features, but enough chit chat, let's see what is new. Starting with a favorite feature that I love on Android, which is the split screen multitasking. Apparently, Samsung will now push this feature even more, give users to go to multitasking mode very easily with just two swipe of fingers. You'll now be able to swipe up from the bottom of the screen with two fingers to access split view, or if you swipe in from the top right corner, you can access the pop-up window mode. This is the beauty of Android, and it's nice that Samsung is pushing these features because we don't have this true type of multitasking on iOS yet. Next up, we have a quick look at the One UI 5.0 notification versus the One UI 4.0, and you can see we have more of a cleaner, more of a refined look to the notification bundles that we have, and it's just looking slightly better than before. Samsung has also changed the background opacity, which is looking a bit dark compared to the lighter look of the One UI 4.0. Samsung could potentially add more changes to this once we see the public beta. Next up is the optical character recognition in the gallery app, which means that now you can actually copy text directly from the photos, something we had on iOS, I think, probably ever since iOS 14, I believe. This is a very handy feature that used to be a part of Bixby Vision, but now it's gonna be with the One UI 5.0 gallery as well as the keyboard. Other than this, with the One UI 5.0, users will be able to turn off or on the UWB option right from the connection settings. If you don't know, UWB is the ultra-wideband technology, and if you turn it off, I guess it's gonna conserve more battery, and now it's just there in the connection settings. Also, with the One UI 5.0, if you go to the About page, you can now see the image of the device, which is kinda nice. Also, there's a new collaboration feature with the Samsung Notes app, which allows you to share notes with up to 100 people. You can also see the current active application with the quick settings, and this is kinda handy because you don't have to go to the multitasking tray to see what is running in the background, so you can kinda see that right at the quick toggle. Now, thanks to Max Weinbach, we now have a look at the One UI 5.0 animations, and this is looking pretty snappy, like really, really, really snappy. A lot of people have mixed opinion on this. Some people like this. I definitely think that it's a good sign because considering it's an internal One UI 5.0 version, not even the beta. So maybe by the time we get the beta, Samsung might add some fluidity to this quickness, which will definitely make the whole experience even better than just having quick, fast-paced animations. Let me know what you think about the animations in the comment section below. Now, One UI 5.0 is said to be focused on key changes like performance and battery life, so it might not bring huge UI changes as previously expected. Samsung is focusing on bringing this update as soon as possible, and then it's rumored that they will release the One UI 5.1 early next year by the time we see the Galaxy S23 series with a lot more big design features and changes, so we'll see how that goes. But this is the first glimpse at the One UI 5.0 based on Android 13, a quick look at the internal One UI 5.0 version, not even the beta. Once the beta is out, which is likely coming out this month, probably at the end of this month, we'll do a proper video, but this is what we have as a form of glimpse. Let me know what you think about this in the comment section below. If you guys are new here, be sure to subscribe. With that being said, I'll see you later. Peace out.